How do you remain true to yourself? Right. And how do you communicate in a way, in an environment where the way you communicate isn't their language? So when you're the only woman sitting around a table with all men, and you're speaking the same way you do with your girlfriends, mm-hmm. it's like going to France and speaking Italian mm-hmm. and wondering why you're not being understood or your ideas aren't being recognized and heard. Right. You know, we have to understand the landscape and do our part to be understood.
And then they all mansplain right on back to
right.
us.
Sure. That's true, too.
Yes. No offense, guys. I know a lot of you are great, but right. it's annoying.
I think your analogy about language, you know, yeah. stepping in, how, and yet at the same time, I think that it's time for a complete reordering mm-hmm. for how we're actually communicating and for men to now flex to our communication style as we become the dominant consumer force in a 70% GDP-driven economy. What does that mean? It means whoever buys stuff controls the outcome of corporate earnings. And so in the next 5 years, the majority of wealth in the United States is going to be in the control of women for the first time mm-hmm. in the nation's history. For the first time in the nation's history, that is a seismic shift, particularly again when most of our economy runs on who's buying stuff. And what's powerful about that and the reason for it, and it transcends age and race. So we sit together within our gender, transcending race, age, and class, and collectively we become a powerful voice in this economy. And if we become the dominant voice in this economy, we are the audience that people are selling to. And if we are the audience that people are selling to, we need to ensure that we're demanding more than just the NFL braiding their daughter's hair on TV or women being in car commercials. So rather than putting a face on it, I think we have, again, back to this seminal moment of being able to reorder the way that these companies operate. And beyond just the C-suite, and beyond top-tier management, that we are present all the way through. Because I think one thing we've learned with Time's Up is that while we may have presence, we're still being treated in the same way because of our gender. Mm-hmm. So executive titles doesn't necessarily equate to power. And unbelievably, it doesn't equate to equal pay. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And if that's the case, then what, in my opinion, that instead of fighting for equal presence, we need to collectively move all of this towards equal pay equity, and that has to be nationalized into the law of the land.